So good morning friends, this is Arvind, Assistant Professor, Department of Cricket, DVSIT, Kavali. So in the previous class I discussed about equivalent circuit of a transformer. Okay, and now in this class I am going to start the losses and efficiency of single phase transformer. So but before going to the losses and efficiency of single phase transformer concept, I am starting one part of it, that is the harmonic free magnetizing current concept. So after that I will start the losses and efficiency of a single phase transformer. So in this one, firstly I will start the harmonic magnetization current. Okay, so actually the harmonic currents are generated by using the non-linear devices. By non-linear devices we are generating the harmonic currents. So the transformer works as a non-linear behavior in the saturated part of the magnetizing curve. Okay, the transformer course has a non-linear behavior in the saturated part of the magnetizing curve. So this non-linear behavior generates harmonic currents in the transformer. Okay, so the transformer core have non-linear behavior in the saturated part of the magnetizing curve. So that means this non-linear behavior generates harmonic currents. So wave shape of the magnetizing current, which is wave shape of the magnetizing current, depends on the applied voltage waveform and the BH curve of the core material. So in the previous class I discussed about the effect of nonlinear BH curve of the magnetizing component, magnetizing material. Okay, so take the same BH curve to explain this harmonic currents in the harmonic in the magnetizing current concept. So here I am taking the wave shape of the magnetizing current, that is depends on the applied voltage waveform and the BH curve of the core material. So since induced voltage is expressed by E is equal to N into d phi by dt, so here the phi belongs to the flux and N belongs to the turns. So in this formula, from this formula E is equal to N into d phi by dt, so in this one phi belongs to flux and N belongs to the turns. So flux wave shape is decided by the voltage wave shape. So flux wave shape is decided by the voltage wave shape. So if you want to know further about this flux and voltage waveform, so please go to the EMF equation concept of the transformer. If you understand that concept, this will also understand. Okay, so thus if the voltage is sinusoidal, okay, if the voltage is sinusoidal, the flux will also be sinusoidal. Why means the flux wave shape is decided by the voltage wave shape. So that means if the voltage is sinusoidal, the flux will also be sinusoidal. And if the voltage is square, the flux will be trapezoidal. So if the ratio of the voltage is square, the flux will be trapezoidal. Next, this is the curve we are talking about. This is the BH curve. So here the curve is drawn between B and H. That is, B is flux density, magnetic flux density, and H is magnetizing force. So here we are drawing the curves. So this is starting from this negative direction to positive direction. So the curve is like this. Okay. So here we have points like A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, so here the A is the middle point of this one. So here the curve is drawn in the fourth quadrant manner. So the curve is appears in the fourth quadrant. Okay, so here we have different types of forces. We have, that is, so if you observe the diagram, this diagram, so at the point A, we have the dotted lines. This red lines use the positive saturation at the point B. So A to B we have the positive saturation, and D to E we have the negative saturation. So the curve is like this. So from A to B we have the positive saturation, and D to E we have negative saturation, and we have negative force, that is corrective force, and we have positive force, that is in the fourth quadrant, that is the corrective force, that is in the positive. So at point B we have the negative force, and point D, at point G we have positive force, and next we have the residual magnetism, that is the positive, that is at the point C, that is the residual magnetism, and at point F we have the residual magnetism in negative direction. So that's why we are taking this BH curve. This BH curve has the negative saturation and positive saturation, and the corrective force in positive direction and negative corrective force in the positive, negative direction, positive direction. Then we have the residual magnetism at positive and negative. Like that, we are taking this curve. And so here the flux density, that is B, okay, the flux density B is proportional to flux for a given core area. Okay, the flux density B is proportional to flux for a core area. And here the flux density is related to magnetizing force H by the BH curve of the core material. Okay, the flux density B is related to the magnetizing force H by the BH curve of the core material. So that means H is related to the magnetizing current. Okay, H is related to, that is magnetizing force H is related to the magnetizing current by the number of turns with fixed core length. Okay, so here the magnetic force that is H is related to the magnetizing current by the number of turns with fixed core length. So thus, if the BH curve is straight line, that is linear, so after we discuss about the nonlinear conditions, so if the BH curve is straight line, that is linear, then the magnetizing current wave will be sinusoidal for a sinusoidal applied voltage. So if it is a sinusoidal, means it is under the unharmonic conditions, that is not in the harmonic condition, it is in the non-harmonic condition. So when it is possible, if the BH curve is straight line, that is linear. So in the previous diagram, we have the BH curve, that is in the fourth quadrant, but in the negative saturation to positive saturation, and we have the corrective forces, and we have the residual magnetism in both positive and negative. So but here, if the BH curve is straight line, that is linear, about four quadrants, so then the magnetizing current wave shape will be sinusoidal for a sinusoidal applied voltage. Okay, so this is the explanation for the harmonics in magnetization current. Okay, next here, so however, in practical cases, so if we want to take a practical, so we design voltage transformers for economy and to reduce size and price. So we will design voltage transformers for economy and to reduce size and price, and we push up the working value of B well above the linear region of the BH curve. So like that, if we design the transformers, we don't have any harmonics in the magnetization current, that is in the transformer. Okay, so next, coming to that, this one, the harmonics in magnetization current, also we have few more points. That is, hence we get a non-sinusoidal magnetizing current waveform. Hence, we get a non-sinusoidal magnetizing current waveform, even if the applied voltage is sinusoidal. So at that time, a non-sinusoidal magnetizing current implies harmonic content unit. Okay, non-sinusoidal magnetizing current implies harmonic content unit. Okay. So if you design a transformer with low values of B, that is low values of flux density, such that it is in the linear region of the BH curve, it is in the linear region of the BH curve, then you will get sinusoidal magnetizing current, sinusoidal applied voltage. Okay, if you design the transformer with low values of B, such that it is in the linear region of the BH curve, then you will get sinusoidal magnetizing current with sinusoidal applied voltage. Like that, we are eliminating the harmonics in the magnetizing current. Okay, so this is the concept of the harmonics in magnetizing current. And next, we will move to the losses in a transformer. So you know already the transformer is a static device, that is a fixed one. Okay. So that is a fixed one means the mechanical losses in the transformer are zero. Okay, the mechanical losses in the transformer are zero. It is not a rigid device. If you have a rigid device like generator and motor, we have the mechanical losses, but the transformer is a static device. That's why we don't have any mechanical losses in the transformer. So that's why I am taking the mechanical losses in transformer are zero. So therefore, the transformer has only iron losses and copper losses. Okay. And coming to the first one, that is iron or copper losses. So the iron loss is caused by the alternating flux in the core. So the iron loss is caused by the alternating flux in the core and consists of hysteresis and eddy current losses. So the iron loss is caused by the alternating flux in the core and consists of hysteresis and eddy current losses. So the core flux in a transformer remains practically constant for all loads. Okay, the core flux in a transformer remains practically constant for all loads, and so the core loss is practically the same at all loads. Okay, so by in respect to the condition, I am telling that the core loss is practically the same at all loads. Why? Because the core flux in a transformer remains practically constant for all loads. That's why we have the core loss the same at all loads. That is the three practical conditions. Okay, so hysteresis loss, that is a W suffix H. So hysteresis loss is the W suffix H is equal to eta into V maximum for 1.6 into F into V max. This is the hysteresis loss formula. W suffix H is equal to eta into V maximum for 1.6 into F into V max. Eddy current loss, this is W suffix E is equal to P into V maximum square, F square, V square, max. Okay, P into V maximum square into F square into V square into that. So hysteresis loss can be minimized by using steel of high silicon content for the core loss. And eddy current loss can be minimized by using very thin lamination. And coming to core loss, copper losses. So the copper loss is due to ohmic resistance of the transformer windings. So the core loss is the copper loss is due to the ohmic resistance of the transformer windings. So if I1 and I2 are the primary and secondary currents respectively, and R1 and R2 are the respective resistances of primary and secondary windings, okay. So the copper losses occurring in primary and secondary windings will be. So the copper losses occurring in primary and secondary windings will be I1 square R1, that is in the primary winding, and I2 square R2, that is in the secondary winding respectively. We have the four copper losses like this in the two windings. So the total copper loss will be the combination of two copper losses in the primary and secondary, I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. So these losses vary as the square of the load current. If these losses vary as square of the load current. So for example, copper loss at half the full load is 1/4 that of that at full load. Okay, for example, copper loss at half the full load is 1/4 of the total full load. Okay, so total losses means the total losses in the transformer are the sum of iron losses and full load copper losses. Okay, the total losses in a transformer are the sum of iron losses and full load copper losses. That is, total losses is equal to iron losses, that is W suffix I, plus full load copper losses, that is W suffix C, U for full load, that is for the full load. So that is, the total losses in a transformer are the sum of the iron losses and full load copper losses, that is total losses is equal to iron losses plus preload copper losses. This is also done as W sub sin plus W sub CU. That is for the full load. That is total losses for X load. That is any load. That is a half load or 1/4 load or 2/3 load like this. If you have that one, that means the formula for the total losses for X load that is equal to W sub I, that is the iron losses, plus X squared, that is the load of the copper, that is X squared into full load copper losses. The WI iron losses plus X squared full load copper losses, that is X squared into full load copper losses. So here X is the load. Okay. So that is the explanation for the losses of transformer. And next, coming to the concept, that is efficiency of transformer. Efficiency of transformer. So that is, you know already the efficiency. So what is the efficiency? The efficiency of the transformer are defined as the ratio of output power to input power. You know already this formula from the generator and motor concepts. Yet the efficiency of the transformer are defined as the ratio of output power, that is P0, to input power, that is PI. That is efficiency. Eta is equal to output power by output power plus iron losses plus copper losses, that is the output power by actual input power. So input power will also written as output power plus losses. So we will written output power plus losses means where the total losses, that is iron losses and copper losses. That's why I am taking output power plus iron losses plus copper losses. So output power is output power of the transformer is V2 into I2 into cos phi. There is a secondary winding voltage into secondary winding current into power factor of cos phi. Output power is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi. So where V2 is the secondary terminal voltage on load and I2 is secondary current at load. Okay. So and cos phi is the power factor of the load. And iron loss, that is PI, that is equal to W0, that is determined from voltage test. And copper loss, PCE, that is the WS, so it is determined from SC test at full load. So in the next classes, I am going to discuss the testing of transformer. In that one, we have two tests, open circuit test and short circuit test. So in the short circuit, in the open circuit test, we have determined iron loss. In the short circuit test, up to at full load, we have determined the copper loss. So I will discuss how to find these iron loss and copper loss by OC and FC test. I will discuss later. And copper loss at no load, at a load, n times the full load, that is equal to n square into P into, that is copper loss, n square into copper loss, that is n square into P suffix Cu. Okay, so transformer efficiency, eta is equal to, so if the copper loss at the load, n times the full load means we are taking a eta n into V, copper loss means we have a total copper loss, that is V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 by n into V2 into I2 into cos phi plus P suffix I plus n square into PCU. Okay, so n times the full load means we have the output power, that is V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 into n by the output power, that is n into V2 into I2 into cos phi plus iron loss, that is P suffix I plus copper loss, that too for the copper loss at a load n times the full load, that is n square into P suffix Cu. Okay, n square into P suffix Cu after here. And next, so that is at full load n is equal to 1. Okay, at full load n is equal to 1, and at a half load n is equal to 1 by 2. Like that, we are substituting in the n place. If we take the full load, that is n is equal to 1, and at a half load n is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, and next, coming to the condition for maximum efficiency. Condition for maximum efficiency. For that one, I am taking the output power, that is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi 2. So output power is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi 2. So here I am taking R02, that is R02. If R02 is the total resistance of the transformer referred to secondary. Why? Because here I am taking output power, so output power will occur on the secondary side. That too at the load condition. So that's why I am taking the output power, that is P0 is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi 2. So if R02 is the total resistance of the transformer referred to secondary, then total copper loss, that is TCU, is equal to I2 square R02, and total loss, that is equal to P suffix I plus P suffix CU. So that is, you know, the formula is eta is equal to output power by input power. So we will rewrite this equation as output power by input power is also written as output power plus losses, that is total losses. So that is equal to output power, you already know, that is V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 divided by output power is V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 plus losses. We have the losses, that is copper loss plus iron loss, that is iron loss is P suffix I plus copper loss is P suffix CU. So from this one we are writing eta is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 by V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 plus PI, that is iron loss, plus copper loss is I2 square R02, that is the copper loss referred to the secondary, that is I2 square into R02. Next, I am taking, so from the above equation, that is eta is equal to V2 into I2 into cos phi 2 divided by E2 into I2 into cos phi 2 plus iron loss, that is PI, plus copper loss, that is I2 square R02. So from that equation, in that equation we are dividing both numerator and denominator by I2. So we are dividing both numerator and denominator by I2, and then we get eta is equal to V2, cos phi, after dividing the numerator and denominator by I2, we have V2 cos phi 2 by V2 cos phi 2 plus PI by I2 plus I2 into R02, and treat this equation as equation number 1. So if we want to calculate the maximum value of efficiency for given power factor, that is cos phi 2, the denominator must have the least value. So the denominator must have the least value. So the condition for maximum efficiency is obtained by differentiating the denominator and equating the denominator to 0, that is d by di2 into denominator, that is equal to 0. So in the denominator we have the v2 cos phi 2 plus pi by i2 plus i2 r02. So please take that denominator with respect to i2, that is d by di2 into v2 cos phi 2 plus pi by i2 plus i2 into r02, that is equal to 0. Differentiating the denominator with respect to i2, and differentiating, we have the formula that is 0. Actually, in the v2 and cos phi 2, we don't have the i2 terms, that's why we are taking that value as 0. And we have pi by, that is 1 by x. You know the formula, that is the differentiation of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. So from that one I am writing minus pi, that is the copper iron loss, by here x is the i2, that is i2 square, plus in the r02 we have the i2, so differentiation of i2 with respect to i2 we have value 1, therefore we have plus r02, and that equal to 0, and after that we have pi is equal to i2 square r02. So you know already i2 square r02 is equal to copper loss, that is P suffix CU. That means in this one iron loss is equal to the maximum power, the maximum efficiency condition is iron loss is equal to copper loss or constant loss, or that is equal to variable loss. Okay, iron loss, that is PI is equal to copper loss, that is I2 square R02, or constant loss. This one is also called the constant loss, and that is equal to variable losses. So hence efficiency of a transformer will be maximum when copper losses are equal to iron losses. Okay, hence efficiency of a transformer will be maximum when copper loss are equal to iron loss. And from equation number 2, that means PI is equal to I2 square R02. So the load current, that is I2, corresponding to maximum efficiency is given by, so I2 is equal to, actually we have I2 square is equal to PI by R02. And after the squaring on both sides, we have I2 is equal to root of iron loss by R02. So this is the load current corresponding to maximum efficiency. Okay, so these are the concepts we are discussing here. That is, firstly I am discussing about the harmonic harmonic current, harmonics in the magnetizing current, and then we are discussing about the losses in a transformer, and then we discussed about the efficiency of a transformer and maximum efficiency condition of a transformer. Then in the next class, I'm going to teach you about the transformer testing, that is open circuit test and short circuit test, and after that I will discuss voltage regulation of a transformer, and after that I will discuss the Simmons test, and after that we will discuss the parallel operation of transformers. Like that we are going to discuss in the next classes. Okay, thank you for watching this video. But here we are given iron loss and full load copper losses. So I forgot to tell about this one. So if we are given iron loss and full load copper loss, then the load corresponding to maximum efficiency is given by, that is full load, that is in the full load KVA. Actually the transformer ratings in the KVA one, that's what I'm taking, full load KVA into root of iron loss by full load copper loss. Okay, iron loss by full load copper loss. Okay, so this is for when we are given iron loss and full load copper loss, then the load corresponding to maximum efficiency, we are taking this full load KVA into root of iron loss by full load copper loss. Okay, thank you for watching this video.